The Section G agent shook his head, bewildered. The old-timer sat down again.
"My son," he said, "runs the farm now. 6 months ago, he traded one of our colts for a small pump powered by one of these. It was little use on my part to argue against the step. The pump eliminates considerable work at the well and in irrigation."
Ronnie still didn't understand.
"The power pack is dead now," the old man said, "and my son needs a new one."
"They're extremely cheap," Ronnie said. "An industrialized planet turns them out in multi-million amounts at practically no cost."
"We have little with which to trade. A few handicrafts at most."
Ronnie said, "But good heavens, man, build yourselves a plant to manufacture the power packs. With a population this small, a factory employing no more than half a dozen men could turn out all you need." The old man was shaking his head. He held up the battery.
"This comes from the planet Archimedes," he said. "One of the most highly industrialized in the UP, so I understand. On Archimedes, do you know how many persons it takes to manufacture this power pack?"
"A handful to operate the whole factory. Archimedes is fully automated." The old man was still moving his head negatively.
"No. It takes the total working population of the planet. How many metals do you think are contained in it in all? I can immediately see what must be lead and copper."
Ronnie said uncomfortably, "Probably at least a dozen, some in microscopic amounts."
"That's right. So we need a highly developed metallurgical industry before we can even begin. Then a developed transportation industry to take the metals to the factory. We need power to run the factory, hydroelectric, solar, or possibly atomic power. We need a tool-making industry to equip the factory, the transport industry, and the power industry. And while the men are employed in these, we need farmers to produce food for them, educators to teach them the sciences and techniques involved, and an entertainment industry to amuse them in their hours of rest. As their lives become more complicated with all this, we need a developed medical industry to keep them in health."